reports from...
Well, not yet, we're not... I'm just front-loading it right now, Walt.
Okay.
You're anxious.
He wants to get out soon.
I don't know if he's even got the camera running yet.
I do.
You do?
I still got 6:59, so we can't start until 7.
Hey, it's a freebie.
You can start early.
That's a freebie.
Lester mill there, no spray?
What? My brother gonna cut down a bunch of trees this week, 'cause I'm afraid they're all gonna start cracking under the cars.
I wouldn't cut them down right now until one stops.
He's gonna do it this week.
Who's the artist?
Looks like a tuber.
Looks like something my granddaughter did.
You should stop over there.
All right, we got 7 o'clock.
You got 7 o'clock. Never mind, I'll tell you later.
I'm all set.
Good evening, folks. We're gonna open the meeting at 7 o'clock with a full board present, recording secretary and account administrator as well. Right, now you can make your motion.
Well, I was gonna let you do public comment, 'cause it's above it.
No.
Yes, it is. Oh, that's old business.
Old business, minutes.
They went for public comment. Okay, yeah. Motion to accept the minutes from, March 2nd.
One of those days.
I second that.
Discussion, gentlemen?
No.
No, just that we made comments on it, the correct, you know.
Yeah, we correct the draft.
Yeah.
I'm good. All right, then, all in favor?
Aye.
While they sign that, we'll run for public comment, do our usual left to right. Leo?
Couple of quick things. One is, thank you for the agenda.
I'm sorry, can you just...
Thank you for the agenda today. Appreciated that, I looked at it, and it was awesome. The other thing is, I've been coming to these meetings for quite a few years, as most of you know. And so I've seen how things were operating and all. And I, you know, when I have a problem, I generally, or something I don't like, I generally voice my opinion. So this time, I gotta say thank you for doing such a great job this year, because sitting through all these meetings, it's worked out, looks like it worked out really well. You guys did a lot of work this year. You got the budget done in time, in a timely fashion. You got it done really good. The people are saving money, things are getting done. You put money aside for the buildings, you know. So, all in all, just to say that, thanks, you did a real great job so far, so...
Oh, thank you, Leo.
If I can complain publicly, I guess I can thank you publicly.
Well, we appreciate that, really. And just kinda echo along that side, I think, you know, the board has done, you know, a good job of trying to stay professional and courteous, and we'd like to, I'd like to try to keep it that way.
You're more citizen-friendly now, you know, and so you get, which is what we always thought should be, is you get more input from the public, and therefore you have more ammunition to use to come with your, come to your decisions, you know? So, very, very citizen-friendly now, so I appreciate that.
Well, thank you very much, we appreciate that. Don't get to hear that very often.
You won't.
Just wanted to hear, right?
Well, that's all I got, thanks.
Donna?
In the spirit of cooperation, I need to unfortunately bring this to your attention to see if there's some way that we can't fix this. The 3 years in a row, there have been errors in the awareness committee's town report page.
Who creates it, if I might ask?
Well, okay, here we go. The top is the one that I submitted, and below are the results that have the error, 2014, 15, 16. I didn't talk to Lee about it this year first, because there had been errors in the past, so when I submitted my report this year, I submitted it in a PDF, which can't be changed, and in a Word document, as she requests, that can be changed. And I said, if for some reason it becomes necessary for you to retype this using the Word file, would you please send me your work before it goes into the report so I can proof it with a second pair of eyes? 2 years ago, there were misspellings, and last year, an odd line was bolded for some reason. I truly understand how busy you are, but in fairness to the committee, who this report represents, we really need to see what is used as a final draft. I know you will understand, and thank you in advance. Good luck with the report. I never got a proof, and there was an error this year. The last line of our mission statement was omitted. I think it's because she reblocked it. She used the Word file and cut and pasted and reblocked things, and I think it dropped.
All I do is highlight it and paste it on the, and I don't read it. I don't have time to read it. I just, that's exactly what I do, Donna.
Okay. So
to everyone's,
it looked like something was reblocked and things got dropped down, but I used exactly the right margins. I did everything I was supposed to.
Which one's which now?
The
black and white is
the one with the circled errors.
Okay, the only thing I see is the, on this one was just the mission statement was not
complete.
It,
the last line was dropped off. The first year there were typos.
I've never typed your report over. Never.
I'm not seeing what last line is.
I've got my originals there.
I can go to my emails.
Please do.
Yeah.
The reason I'm bringing it to the attention is I want to find a cure for it.
Well, we can spend $400 to $600 and I can give it all to the printer and I won't handle any of them.
Okay, my question is, and it's not a personal attack, Lee, please don't take it that way. My question is, the town administrator is the highest paid person in town.
No, that's not a true statement.
Well, who is the highest? I don't know who it is.
Not throwing anybody on the bus, but actually it's the police chief.
Okay, well, what I mean, in the town office, I apologize. Highest paid, and I'm not really sure that the town administrator should be doing that type of clerical work. I'm almost of the mind that it should be a person that is more of a secretary that is trained in those programs.
Funny you mention that. That's why we put money in the budget this year to try to get another assistant part-time to help out, because we recognize the fact that she's doing work that's beyond, you know, below her pay grade, not necessarily, you know, not to be disrespectful to that.
No, I understand that. That's what I'm saying.
It's below her pay grade, and we're trying to get some more help in there to help her out so she can focus on what she really needs to focus on, and this kind of stuff to the people that are paid for that type of work.
In line with that, I do agree that we may, in fact, need some extra help in the town office, but have we ever brought in an unbiased outside person to do an efficiency evaluation of who does what?
Yep.
Did we?
Mm-hmm.
Who? When?
It was
2.5 years ago.
Yeah, local government center,
yeah.
Under our property liability insurance.
PLT insurance
paid $14,000 to have an assessment of.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And they recommended extra hours?
I'd have to review that.
I have to read it. It's been a while.
Yeah.
They basically said that there wasn't enough help.
Mm-hmm.
For the workload, and there wasn't enough security or privacy.
You can come up for
right.
You can
okay, because I was thinking in terms of how to free up more time, obviously, and one of the things that keeps, and this made me think of it even more, is payroll. I mean, I understand we have some people that are paid monthly, some people that are paid, the rest all paid semi-weekly, bi-weekly, weekly, or would we
have...
Depends
on the position.
Yeah,
it's
so
paid at once every quarter.
Okay, so I understand that. I'm just wondering if we've ever even looked at some things like payroll service, being a payroll service instead of doing it in-house, making it more uniform, like every 2 weeks, and farming it out. Because, you know, for every dollar we spend on salary here for somebody to do something, you have to add in, what, another 30% for benefits and taxes, etc. So a lot of times a service is a more economical thing, and when you farm that out, you end up with leftover hours at the office. So it's another way of getting extra hours without hiring somebody.
We've looked into that.
You have?
Payroll services.
How long
the
ago?
Problem with that is that you still have to have that individual that collects all the timesheets,
uh-huh.
That makes sure that nothing is missing on the list, that has to coordinate either overnight express this to the payroll service company, or find the time to scan the information. So there's still a contact person in the office. So now you've taken that responsibility away from them, frees up their time, but then they have to go back.
Yeah, my sister owns a payroll company, and she gets everything electronically from the people that she does the payroll with.
Yeah,
it comes through electronically, so it's just typed in. I'm just mentioning it because, in fact, when you have a situation like this where you have a person making big bucks, it's having to learn programs that I don't think they should have to learn. And if it's so difficult that if somebody submits something with the proper margins, the proper everything, and it has to be cut and paste. Why, I would like to submit things in a PDF so they can't be changed. But I'm told we have to submit them in a Word doc.
But what we've found in the printing company has pointed it out, is that they will be blurry. And, you know, I don't have a problem using PDFs, but they will come out blurry.
Why?
Because we're putting a PDF on a Word document. It's just,
that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, I know, I've done that myself. You cut and paste from a PDF and put it into a Word document. It doesn't always translate very well, and it come in as sharp sometimes. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. Depends on the quality of the PDF.
Yeah.
But going back to your concern is that it was wrong 2 years in a row.
And I brought it to attention.
Right.
And
but before, I think for this coming year, before it goes to print, I think the common sense thing is to do is someone from the committee initials off on it before it goes to print.
I asked for that, and she didn't give it to me. I said, "Can you please send me?"
I think we can try that. Do that this year. That way, you can have the final look at your section.
I think everybody should have a final look. I know there have been some other mistakes, so
I think
when
that
you're
would
putting
be a,
something together that thick,
like fonts,
with that much information, you know, and there is a chance when you're submitting in a Word file for to change.
Was that one sent to me from Linda Nickerson this year? I thought she filled in and sent me something.
Yeah. She sent you the Garden Club page. No, this is mine. It's just that page, because I deal with old town reports, the town report is forever.
These go together. Submitted and report.
It's always different when you print something from your home, because Allison, over, you can ask her over and over and over. She would send minutes, and then the minutes would be add a space here and shift everything down, and so it's the version of the Word that she was using that was uploading to a different version. I mean, there was, and just to try to straighten the format out, you're not doing anything to change the intent of the article. You're just trying to make it so that if there's a space and another sentence started three words after, you know, into a new line, it's just common courtesy to back it up.
Who do we use for a printer? Who do we use for a printer?
They're in Concord. I don't know the name of the...
Is it a standard template that they give you, a program that they give you, a standard template that you have to fill in the blanks?
No, not at all. If we wanted to do that, it would cost the town $400 to $600 for them to take our documents and consolidate them. Did I leave an email in your... It was just basically saying, I am trying my hardest to do, you know, whatever I need to do to keep cut corners, and this has been, you know...
The town report costs us $5,207 this year.
I know. Oh, okay.
And that's for 1,150 of them at 143 pages each.
That's not...
But so it's not a program?
No. I'm taking Excel, PDFs, Jeff Trexler does the CIC, some people put encryptions in there, and I have sent their examples or my changes back to them to ask them to either create a chart like you've done before. You put a box of rows in there, then you turn them invisible, and it keeps the format there, and it doesn't shift when you're going from your Word version to my Word version. And I know better. I'm not going to intentionally change someone's
No one said you were intentionally changing it.
Right.
I think the blocks were, if you hold the two pages up to a light, you'll see that the blocks are different size. And when that happened, it dropped everything down one line.
And it might have been the page above it had an extra space, and I didn't see it, and it shifted it down just one. And did you notice that it was printed on the other page? Because I've also noticed my document, it was finished with all the headers on the top.
Yeah.
1 year, maybe last year, there were like three documents. The Board of Assessors, the title was on the next page. And that I didn't catch. It was already past the proof stage. But there's only like 3 days for me to proof it, make sure I haven't missed any records. I have two people reviewing for punctuation and grammar. We don't change, you know...
The wording.
The wording at all. I mean,
well,
the year there was a
misspelling, you did actually reblock everything because you told me you did, and that's how one of the words went. The spelling was misspelled, and things were kept. That you did do that year.
I thought That year, like 2014?
2014 here.
Yes.
And that could also be, you know, the Word, going from Word, we'll take and have their stuff in there, and you can...
They don't change the spelling of words.
No, they don't, I'm just saying that, you know, if you, but it'll highlight something, like the, I know it's like the capital letters on one and not capital on the other.
That's, you have to go back and change it, and that's what I did when I had, if the PDF had been used, it wouldn't have changed.
I mean, the first year, Dawn, I, you have to admit, I sent it back to you like 4 times, and you sent them back to me.
I know. Yes, I know. Yes.
It's not like I was trying, not trying to work for you.
I'd say we just send that when it's ready for the last, the 3 days before it goes to printer, we send out an email to every department to come in and look at your proofs.
Perfect, and that's what it is, you have to look at it in my paper format, because as soon as I send it out to you, it could change again.
That's fine, that's what we do.
I think that's a solution.
And I think that's the loose, we all come in and sign off.
And that's, you have the final say so.
That's what I wanted to hear, I wanted to hear that we could come up with a way to get around it. Because I actually would like to see it expand, I would like to see more private groups have a page in the back of the town report.
If they want to take and pay for it, that's all.
That's great, so I don't want to add to something that's already a problem, though.
So with that being said, I noticed again, and it's very, very difficult for us in the Historical Awareness Committee, that the Historical Society's page is when, in the business section of the town report, and what that does is everybody thinks that we are them, and we have issues with this, and that page should be in the back of the town report with other organizations, so that way, because it looks exactly like they are us, and we are them. So it's...
I do push them to the back.
No, it's in the business section.
It's in page 85.
Business section?
Yeah, you know, where all of the other committees and the...
Town committees are?
Yeah, and then you put...
So you're thinking it should go in the very end, where the Garden Club is?
Well, where the Garden Club is, sure, yeah, because it's an organization in town.
I don't recall that at all, I don't.
Yeah, it was said, you said you would do it. The other thing is, it actually works to their disadvantage to have it in the middle of the thing like that, because what happens is when someone reads it, especially this year when they're talking about how they need this, and how they need that, et cetera, people flip through and they go, oh, that's a town organization, they'll be taken care of, no problem. But if you see them in the back of the book, and there's a page differential, these are private organizations, now all of a sudden, someone's looking, oh, gee, this is a private entity in town that needs some help.
I mean, I...
So it works to their disadvantage to be in the middle.
I even made a mistake on the Garden Club, for some reason, I just spaced it, I thought it was yellow sheet.
But I mean, I really think that that has to be separated, because it just makes it look like it's a town entity, and we've done things and got no credit, where they get the credit for all the work, so it's...
It's too easy.
It's futile.
It's too easy, yeah.
Yeah, so just bring it up to your attention, that's all.
Yep.
Yeah, just, and I know it's public comment, so if I can weigh in.
Sure.
I've had two complaints, well, not complaints, but curiosities. One from a neighbor today was talking to me about, how much money do we give the Historical Society Committee? I said, they're not a committee, they're a private entity.
Yeah, so it makes sense to move them to the back.
So moving it to the back would probably be a lot more helpful.
I can also recategorize it in the index, so that I can put other, how did you word it?
I would say private organizations.
Private, just do a little subheadle.
Dunbarton Family Organizations.
Private and civic organizations, and let's get these people to get some pages in there, so we know whoever you've got. I want to know what 4-H does, I want to know what these other groups do. This is how in a town without a newspaper, without a radio station, without a flyer, this is how you find out who's doing what.
Good editor.
The river does not run through it.
Since we're on the subject, as you start to expand on this, there's added cost to it. Do I start saying I'm gonna bill you for your page? I mean...
Well, we do for the Garden Club.
We do, they've always volunteered.
Yeah, we don't want taxpayers paying for our page.
I mean...
And I think that, you know, we've talked before, we could, if some volunteer wanted to take it on, because certainly nobody here has time to do it, people could pay for advertising in the back, and there could be in the back there, they could have business cards, and they could pay for it, and it could help fund the darn report.
Yeah.
But it would have to be Dunbarton businesses only, you know, Corin's Tea Place, and all these little ones, just pay for a business card in there, and you could have that whole thing set up in there, and now you're getting money towards paying for it.
But you almost need a volunteer to organize that, so that it doesn't, exactly.
Sell the spaces, yeah.
Sell the spaces and do it. And taking on that extra.
She can take on money, but if it were done, so all it was added. The intention here is not to add any cost to what the town is already doing.
Or work.
When we looked into doing that for the cost of the website, and then I think the board at the time.
Oh, that would have been awful.
Discussed that there's some legal issues, who authorizes, you know, 30 days, 6 months, a year, you can't, I mean, there's a lot involved. I mean, Linda can vouch for me, that website's not user-friendly. Do you have a problem using that?
I have no problem with it, and I like the fact there are not a lot of ads on it. I am so sick of pop-up ads and everything
going. It's a little bit complicated to get in there.
I just want the facts, Jack.
Yeah. I think that files could be laid out a little differently, but it was our first time putting a website together.
I know how to use it inside and out, but for me to say, okay, I'm going to train, you know, Steve or Joe Marie to use the website, it's really, takes a long time to feel comfortable using it. I mean,
I'd be happy to write up a volunteer opportunity thing and submit it to you to advertise.
Appreciate that.
There you go.
I just want to kind of just bring this back into, you know, the public comment kind of thing. It's been a good conversation, don't get me wrong, but I mean, I don't want to just take and go on a tangent for the next 2 hours.
Thank you for listening.
You got anything else?
Nope, all set.
Okay. I'm going. Don't worry. You're next.
This is related to public comment.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm ready to let.
Yeah.
I think the idea of adding pages at the end of the town report, mm-hmm. Allowing different groups in town to be able to say what they're doing makes mm-hmm. a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. It may be helpful for you to write a policy about how someone submits, how much it costs, that kind mm-hmm. of thing, mm-hmm. so that then every group knows it's clear, you can refer them to the policy, and they know what's involved.
Yep, absolutely. Thank you. Read my mind. I was kind of thinking that in the back of my head while everybody was talking. So.
Something new. You just got to establish some ground rules.
Yeah,
exactly.
And that way it's fair for everybody.
Right.
I'll fill those out for you.
Anything else for me?
No, just the plot.
Les, you got anything for the good of the order?
No, thank you for offering.
No problem. Linda, kind of start with you.
Nothing for public comment, thank you.
Woody?
A couple of quick things. One you probably already know of, we had a vehicle hit one of the buildings at the transfer.
First I've heard of it. Maybe someone else does.
Okay. But I didn't know she's been busy, so I don't know if she had time to tell you. But anyways, yeah, we had a vehicle.
Private vehicle or?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So it wasn't one of our people driving into it?
No, it was a private vehicle right to the side of one of the buildings. Some minor damage.
Very minor.
Police department. They came down, did a report, they have pictures and that sort of stuff.
Do we have an accident report process for the town?
Yeah, we do. I haven't gotten a report from the PD yet.
I didn't get into the building until 2:00 this afternoon.
No. I meant just as in, you know, like, what do you, you know, have it? I know, like, in the state system, if there's an accident, whether it's, you know, workers' comp or whether it's a vehicle or anything like that, we have our own form to do our own report, you know, in addition to any police reports or anybody else for that matter.
There's going to be a police accident report that's been started. If you haven't been finished,
mm-hmm.
I wanted to send Lee photos yesterday, but we missed the photo with the damage to the building because there was some miscommunication of what the damage was. I took that yesterday afternoon, and I never got an opportunity to send it to her today.
Is there liability on the part? Is liability on the person who drove the vehicle into the building?
There could be, but the damage is really pretty minor.
Okay.
It's some of that, the trim board's got, the plastic trim board's been crushed.
So it may not be worth pursuing.
I wouldn't pursue it.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, and like I explained to the chief, I think we have some leftover material from when they actually did the trim work.
Yeah.
Once again, like him, mm-hmm. we kind of been sharing the same hat today a little bit. So.
And no injuries to the driver?
Yeah. No, it was very minor.
No damage to the vehicle.
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
The other thing.
Just like to document it so that way for the insurance company down the road, you know, that way anything ever happens and it comes up and like, oh, what do you know about this one?
I think you guys usually get the report in your basket once it's been submitted to us.
Okay.
The other thing, the last two windstorms, we're noticing some shingles around the yard. So when it's not windy, we'll get a little better look at one of the roofs down there and see if it, three of them I can see, three sides, the fourth side I can't see because it's about 40 feet off the ground, but when it's not windy, we'll check it out and see if the shingles are coming off from our roof or where they're coming from.
That goes the same for us.
Maybe they're coming out of the construction debris, hopefully.
This building?
Yeah, for all measure at that end of the yard, so I'm a little concerned.
I can wish, can't I?
Yes. That's all I got.
We picked up two pieces of shingle off of this building, in front of the building. Okay.
Just say there's no slate coming off.
Oh, oh my God.
Oh. Don't jinx us. Please, let's not go there.
Come on.
Too early to... Yeah. No, this is like a scare the pants off of somebody. Chief.
The only comment I have is on the annual report.
Mm-hmm.
The annual report is an official town document. It's a permanently recorded historical document. I think it's not the place for advertisements of any kind. It's not a program or a playbill or anything like that. There shouldn't be any advertisements in that.
I appreciate the feedback. Anybody else going once? Please. All right, I'm going to close public comment and we'll start with our agenda. Thank you, folks. That was an interesting exchange. Appreciate that. Randy, you're first.
Okay. So, I hear we're going to have an election on Tuesday, and then a little meeting following the election. But I'm here to talk about the election. And I think I really only have two things at this point.
Mm-hmm.
And one is setting up the community center.
I was going to ask that last week, and it slipped my mind because it was on the email I sent you, and it just somehow we spaced it.
We don't have much help left.
Brad did it last.
Yeah.
Last time. I don't know if have you touched base with Brad?
Yeah, I'll give him a call.
Or I have.
You have touched. Did he say whether he was going interested?
Yeah, it would be late in the day, though.
Yeah, well, you did last time.
It was after 4 o'clock,
right,
was kind of what
Monday
he expressed
afternoon.
To me.
As I talk to the folks over at school, if we get there like at 4:30, that's helpful to them.
Mm-hmm.
With the after-school program, by that point, it's pretty easy for them to have the kids upstairs.
Yep.
It's also easier for me to get there around 4:30. That time works for me.
Yeah, I'll help like I did last time, come in and help out with Brad and get them up.
Yeah, I have to be here until 5 o'clock by law because of absentee ballots, so I can't be down there to help set up.
We just basically get some tables out and get the booths up. We don't need that. How many booths do we need? Because it's a town meeting, it's not a federal.
I'll know that better on Sunday.
It's one booth for every 100 voters on the checklist, I believe.
I think it's fewer than that.
Depends on the type of election, there's different requirements.
The only differentiation is in a presidential primary, the numbers are either 100. Or one booth for every 100 voters, and then the other one is one booth for every 125 voters, and one of them is very specific to a type of election. But those are the only two options.
I'm thinking whatever it is, if we have extra room, we might want to set up extra booths.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be there, so I can
right.
determine that.
I just don't think we'll have the turnout like we do with the presidential.
Oh, we certainly won't, but we've got a 3 ballots, and one of them is a lot of reading, if you haven't prepared yourself ahead of time.
Yeah.
So, we were just talking about this, I'm guessing that if we have a backup, it's not going to be at the ballot clerks like it was at the federal election, it's going to be in the ballot booths. As
could
people
be.
Are trying to work their way through the ballot. So, but we can talk more about that on Monday. The other thing is that the local election, it's a very different election in terms of who we have working at it. You're all election officials, we're election officials, we have others in town, but an election official cannot work within the rail. If they are on the ballot for a race that is not an election official race. So, I'm an election official. I'm running for school district moderator. That's an election official position. And so, because both are, the same set of ethics applies to me, and so I can be a part of the election. I can't be a part of counting the ballots at the end of the day for the race that I'm in. Brian, you're running for a position that is not an election official, and so the law is very clear. You can't participate in, you can't act as an election official in that election, much to my chagrin.
But I'm also running as an election official, too.
I know.
But the fact that you're on the ballot as a non-election official position automatically disqualifies you.
So,
okay.
Yeah.
I checked with Dave Scanlon.
I'll come back to that.
Being shorthanded.
So Pam will also not be able to participate. I wanted to make sure we understood how it's going to work now. Michael, you're in a different spot. There's other considerations. By the law, you could be there. You could be handling ballots, but there's a listserv for moderators in the state, and I threw this question out there. The overwhelming, I think I got 20 responses, and almost all of them talked about, it's not just the law, it's about how people perceive things. And as much as I would love to inaugurate you and get you working as hard as I can as an election official your first time out, I think it might be better to suggest you sit this one out.
Any capacity for me at all, that I can set up.
I think the risk is that it looks like you're electioneering.
Okay.
And that, of course, is not allowed within
absolutely
the area. So,
no buttons.
Yeah. Well, I can't be there.
Well, you can vote.
I can. My ballot, I can handle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. By law, you could, but I'm suggesting that maybe it's better that you're not.
Okay.
And if I could only apply that logic to me to get me out of having to be there that day, that would be great. But I can't. So
that next year, we'll have to take it.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Exactly. I think we have to be very careful because there was a town just listed in the news this week. The election was voided.
Those were a month away.
Really?
And it was a secretary. Well, it was recently. Secretary of State was called, and they voided the election. They got to do it all over again.
Not in our backyard.
Right.
Yeah. But I think it was Vermont, actually.
Oh, Vermont. Excuse me, Vermont.
Yeah.
But still, it's too close to home, and we don't need to do anything dumb.
We'll keep it clear.
Yeah.
Bob, I'm hoping that you will be able to be there. I'll be able to use you as much of the day as you can be.
I'm going to be there for most of the day.
Yeah. The most...
most of the evening, too.
The busiest time we anticipate will be between 4 and 7. Mm-hmm. So if you can do that, that would be great.
Well, actually, I'll be there before you open up, as we were last time.
Yeah.
And through most of that day, I may skip out around noon time, and then I'd be back probably by 1:30. You know, I won't be gone very long.
Okay.
And they can appoint a moderator pro tem, or not a moderator, a selectman pro tem for that day to fill your place. And then you wouldn't even have to be there for the signing off on the ballot box at the end of the night.
I wouldn't ask anybody to do that, because that's...
It's
a long day, and I understand maybe during the day or something of that nature would be one thing, but
that does come back around to even though you can't count the ballots, you have to be there as we are finishing the evening.
Oh,
so we'll need all
three. Once they're done and counted, there's a no story that we could do everything we have to do, which is
And actually, if you are there late in the evening, you can help with breaking down, the stuff that helps to get us out earlier.
That doesn't matter.
That's why I took Wednesday off, too, because I figured it'd be late at night.
Yeah.
Okay. Besides that, I think we're in pretty good shape.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Is anyone on our end? Ballot counters? You got enough of them?
Yeah.
We haven't even been recruiting. Boy, have you recruited some ballot counters?
I've tried. I haven't gotten much response
yet. Actually, I think we could, like someone like Mike and I could actually count ballots from the school side.
I think you can count them in the school side. I know Fred would do that before. Would have you do the school ballot or the zoning ballot.
Yeah.
But I'm not, are they even permitted in the guardrail? Dave's getting.
Well, it's not the guardrail, is it, anymore?
When your counting area.
Yeah.
Becomes the guardrail.
Again, it goes back to perception, we shouldn't be handling close to the balance.
I know they have done that in the past.
Well, let's see, we often can recruit a number of counters during the day.
If you guys want to help, you could recruit all kinds of counters for us between now and then.
Yeah, I've never seen any shortage of volunteers at any election.
Usually snag it as they come through.
I was twisting arms to get them to the federal, yeah.
In the federal, yeah.
And we were lucky to get as many as we did, but I've seen it worse.
There's a lot of begging and cajoling.
Okay, I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
I was just, thought I was being snookered into it.
Especially this one. This is the hardest one to get ballot counters for because the evening ends so late.
Gotcha.
We can't start counting the ballots until the meeting's over.
Well, hopefully it'll go smoother. There seems to be not too many contentious warrant articles, so.
Not our turn this year, yeah.
And it's not a big warrant, you know.
It's not a big warrant.
Yeah, that helps. No, I would agree, if you know some folks. My effort this year has been to try to find people who might want to be, start to learn how to be a ballot clerk. But I'm looking for younger people in town. So you're a friend. And I think counting the ballots, I mean, it's a strange kind of fun, but it can be kind of fun. And it's a great way to get started with
heads off.
It's
great. Part of the same process.
That's how I ended up here. Irene snagged me to come be a ballot counter. The next thing I knew, I was a ballot clerk. And then I'm a deputy town clerk.
You need to get your feet wet.
Yeah. Linda, what is the age? Is there an age level that they have?
18, right?
It's, you have to be 18 by the time of the next election.
By the time
so that would mean about 17 and a half.
Would any of our high school students at Bow?
They have to be residents.
At this point, we don't even have.
What about, that's easily done by going through the school system that we want to recruit.
At this point, we don't have any kids at Bow who are that old.
We don't.
They're still at Goffstown.
Oh, yeah.
And for the last election, I tried to recruit kids for them and got nothing. So. It's a great idea. I think it would have to be if you knew somebody to ask them specifically, because the blanket request didn't get a response.
And even if you know, they know they're getting paid, they still don't want to do it.
Yeah.
We're not going to go there.
Years ago, a lot of the ballot counters were taken actually just forego the pay and just do it as a volunteer.
Oh, yeah.
But more and more, I know signing the manifest, more and more of them taking the pay now.
Really?
Actually, it's really the regular election workers, the ballot counters. Almost every one of them volunteers.
I've never
signed in quite a few.
I've never seen anybody sign in.
Hardly ever have anybody. Maybe one every election.
Yeah.
That's it. But you probably see the ones for the ballot clerks.
That too.
That's going to be bigger.
And those are going to be bigger, and the supervisors and the checklist. They don't regularly get to watch the counters. Most of them do it as a volunteer.
Yeah, I'm sure I'm from my memory here, but.
I put it together.
Get old, like I resigned.
Because you'll see donate down the list,
yeah.
And then just maybe one person will say, I'll put mail, because Allison needs to know whether to mail it or what actions.
Any questions for me?
It should go in pretty well. I'm assuming the meeting, ideally, if we could kind of keep the meeting on track and so we don't make it a long night, professional courtesy, sometimes people get a little rowdy, and vocal. As long as they're respectful, I mean, that's just my personal opinion.
That's the whole plan. That we're able to discuss each issue respectfully and stay on track so we can keep the evening moving.
Has Lou DiBerio been in touch with you? I did give him your email request to speak.
Yes, milfoil.
Yeah.
On milfoil.
Yeah, and I let him know that it would be something that we'd have to ask the town at the meeting.
Yeah.
But it's great that he got a hold of me.
Yeah.
Helpful. No surprises.
No, and that list I gave you for speakers, did I give you the list of warrant articles for speaker?
Yep. Okay.
At least you'll know who to look for when the time comes.
No surprises, very helpful.
The last one that Bob Leonard's put in the petition warrant article, it's an illegal warrant article. I don't know, we might get some people asking questions about that, so.
He is still trying to pursue mending it on the floor. He was in again today. He wrote up the change, and I've sent it to our representative at the DRA.
And the legal counsel, make sure it passes muster, because we can't really change the intent of it, so.
Right, right.
Because I understand it, so.
Yeah, well, yeah, because that's the other side of no surprises. No surprises for the town.
Right.
That we don't end up acting on something that people didn't expect because it wasn't in the warrant. That would be right.
Yeah.
But also, you know, we vote in an illegal warrant article we can't act on, and then people are like, well, we voted in, why didn't you do it? And then we look like the bad guys, and it's like, we can't.
So I've recently gone to moderator school as well, and one of the things that we talked a lot about was how much latitude do I have to comment on things like that? And I have some, but not a ton.
No.
And so when there's an issue, a legal issue, that is important to the article, it can be very helpful to have a town attorney there, because then we can get them recognized to speak, and they can speak.
I don't know if we need a town attorney for this particular one. I mean, because if they pass it and it's illegal, then it just stands as an illegal warrant article and won't be done.
Yeah.
You know, but it'll be passed.
But as you said, then there are consequences for you all
having
to explain why you're not acting on it.
And maybe that night at the meeting, if there's even a question about the legality of it, you could prep the voters ahead of time and say, there's a chance that this article doesn't fall into the parameters, so.
Right.
Right. And then you warn them, and then in the interest of saving money, we're not going to have a town attorney sit here for our meeting. Because that would be costly.
Especially the last article of the day, pretty much. I mean, that's a long time for the family attorney to sit there and say, it's illegal, sorry, walk away.
It's their call, but then if you could show the voters ahead of time the possibility.
So if you've got concerns about the legality, might be good for you to speak to it.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's a good idea.
All right, who's the lawyer here on the board? Yeah, we'll have to be just prepared for that.
Hopefully the answer that comes back from the DRA is the same as what we've gotten from our town attorney, and then it's done.
Yeah.
And it would be something that they could just
And it's something that you could mention.
Right.
I mean, I understand where he's coming from, and I think, you know, and the intent of it, I can see where he's coming from, but.
I think he merely stated the long RSA.
RSA is.
And that was the mix-up. Not a mix-up, but that was the error that was made in drafting it. And it was no malice intended, but I think his goal was to reward him for next year.
Right.
It didn't sound like he was trying to fool anybody in that he's the one who brought up that there was a problem with it. Mm-hmm.
Well,
no,
the attorney, no, the
attorney did.
Yeah.
Right. Let him know.
The meeting I was at where it came up, he's the one who brought it up.
So okay.
I don't think he's trying to fool anybody.
No.
Well, he's very mental with the fact that it is what it is. All right, I'm good. Anything more, Rainey?
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
And look forward to working with you next week.
Yeah. The downside is we're going to have Brian running the tally table. It's really good at that.
I've appreciated all your hard work. I will again.
All right.
Thank you.
Good
night.
Have a good night, Rainey. Thank you.
She's okay.
All right, next on the list is the Boston Post Cane Award. Now, are we actually awarding tonight, or do we want to do it at a town meeting?
I believe you need to do it at town meeting, right, Linda?
They've done it at town meeting.
Correct.
Well, we've all read the notice here from the historical society that did the work on the Boston Post Cane. They put ballot boxes out in the town, and we have three individuals here. Catherine May Calvo, 1921. We got Marion Crosby, 1922, and Fred Mills in 1929.
Mm-hmm.
Are you on that list there? Yes.
Almost.
I'm just kidding you.
So who is the oldest person?
Pardon?
Who is the oldest person?
Catherine Belvo, Marion Crosby, and Fred Mills Jr.
Yeah.
The oldest person. All right, so we have Catherine May Belvo as the oldest person at this point in time that we can determine now. I'll make a motion that we award the Boston Post Cane to Catherine May Belvo, at the town meeting as the Boston Post King recipient, as the oldest resident in town. That's my motion.
I'll second that.
Discussion, gentlemen. I think it's a very good done deal, it's easy. All right, all those.
At least they found the person that should actually get the points.
Yep, absolutely. Well, I know Colonel Radio personally, I mean, he knew me before I was even born, the previous holder. He's a real good guy, so hopefully, you know, it's a good, it's moving on to another excellent resident and he can take care of.
I mean, there was quite a bit of effort put in.
Can you give you a copy of it? Yes, I did.
All in favor?
Aye.
That being the case, I'd like to thank the Historical Society for doing, the heavy lifting on this and for their help on that. And now we have to get contact.
I'll get in touch with the family.
Family, and, you know, and hopefully she can make it to the town meeting. If not, at least the representative that can take and accept it on her behalf. If anybody is curious, we have it here. Actually, it's a little heavier than I thought.
Is that a replica?
Yeah.
It is, right?
Presented by the Boston Post to the oldest citizens of Dunbar, New Hampshire, to be transmitted.
I think I can wait a while.
Yeah, I got a few years. If my dad was alive, he'd actually be the oldest resident, because he was born in 1920. If my dad was. All right. Reese across Dunbar, Don Larson, I don't see him here.
No.
But there was something in the mailbox here.
Yep, there's something in the mailbox.
We don't do this anymore, because we've done that.
That was,
Reese across here from DRA, says we have adopted RSA 31:95.
Yep.
And we can accept, we as a board of selectmen can accept the funds to be used, in this case, at the request of Reese across Dunbar. So we can accept them and
That would be the proper process to put it on the agenda, unanticipated revenue, make a motion to accept it and then earmark it or.
Put in the account for that.
Correct, yeah.
Now, do we have to set up a trust fund for that of sorts, or?
No, it would be the same as the
Just accounting.
Energy committee.
Gotcha. All right, well then. I don't have a problem with myself personally. All right, next we have general town business. I assume we're gonna take in.
Job description.
Job description, is that you want to do it tonight, or are we just gonna take a look at first?
I think we probably need to look at it.
Tonight or tomorrow, or for next week?
We can have it ready for next week.
I'd like to review it, you know, before we talk.
Yeah, and I did send it to you electronically, so if you wanna make changes and track changes.
Okay.
Do that.
Okay, great.
Mr. Rollo. Hey, you're just in time.
What?
Well, you almost made it as a Boston Post King recipient, but you left town in time.
Why, am I the oldest?
You would have been.
Really?
Just kidding.
Awesome. Great, I thought you needed a cane, though. I really could.
Just kidding, it's good to see you. All right.
General town business, I'd just like to, since we're transfer station, Woody, Woody here.
Oh, yes. Yes, absolutely, go for it.
Woody, I saw some email traffic concerning the potential of having high school students work Wednesday evenings and maybe Saturdays. Do you think that might be a possibility? Not at all.
I talked to the Department of Labor and they said absolutely not. I called the Department of Labor.
Yeah.
And
whom did you talk to?
Her name was Michelle.
Michelle?
Because the thing is, I was reading that some of the information was coming out that we can maybe bring him on as an apprentice, or if we can bring him on and not use machinery. I mean, there's some specific guidelines about not.
They can't even, in my understanding, she didn't confirm it, but it had been confirmed in the past. You can't be within 50 feet of the machinery. That's from the past. She didn't confirm that when I talked to her on Wednesday. But she did confirm that they cannot load the balers. Even though they're not running, they cannot load them.
Okay, but...
So basically, it does no good to have someone there that you still have to do their work. You know what I mean? They might be sorting.
Yeah.
But now you've got to empty their stuff. That's not a help, that's a hindrance.
Okay.
You know what I mean? It's a good idea.
Yeah, but I just saw the email traffic. It seemed like there was, leaving out some information that was kind of like,
I saw what you wrote.
Yeah.
Then I saw it come back, and I said, geez, that sounds like it could be still a possibility.
Yeah, and I said, I called in the meantime and asked this, so I had clarification.
Yeah.
So you know, we put our two heads together, we might come up with an actual answer. Mm-hmm. And that's what she told me. She said, no. Okay. And she actually called and then called back. She asked about the equipment. I said, what about, you know, they're not running it, obviously, but what
right.
about just dumping the material in?
Yeah, that's where I heard the word apprentice come in. If they were underage, you could...
She didn't say anything about being an apprentice, nothing. Yeah. She just said no. What I got.
Are you going to do one more follow-up with her on that? Or
no, I don't have time right now.
Okay.
I am maxed out as it is. I have to work tomorrow because I can't get everything done.
Yeah.
I got trucking to do. Yeah, it's got to go.
Well, the goal here is we're trying to get you some help.
Yeah.
Even albeit
and
small.
And you know, it sounds like it's a plus, but it's really not a plus. If we got to hold their hand, we're not geared to be babysitting. I don't have the people. We're just, it's too busy in there. I mean, even us guys that are experienced
yeah.
with it, you get mindset. You're in your own zone. You got to be. The material's coming at you. You got to be able, you can't.
Okay.
It's a nice idea. I'm not going to say it's not.
Okay.
But I just think at this time, I mean, we have a potential for something we're going to discuss later.
Yeah, I heard we have an applicant.
Right. And so now... That's like I'm having two or three for one guy to do. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm very well stressed and very low maxed right now.
Okay. All right. Well, we're just trying to think a little bit out of the box
yeah.
here, and because what we don't want to do is shortchange residents and then have like I can just see it on a Saturday having 30 cars lined up to get to the transfer station. That's what's going to, I think, I see that happening.
Okay,
and then we're going to have to call a chief down because people are going to get irate and they're going to start throwing stuff on the outside of the transfer station.
Have to be there directing traffic.
And stopping people from just throwing this stuff around.
That's not the
way.
I don't want to say, the thing is, what I want to do is take measures to avoid any crisis down there.
Absolutely.
And that's my concern. So
no, and
we're
going
to continue to think out of the box on behalf of the residents.
Yeah, yeah. I know. I totally agree with it, but I just think that it's going to be more of a hindrance than it is.
Understood.
A
help. Okay.
You know, the backup's going to happen. We're short-handed this weekend. So
yeah, I didn't think
you know, there's only three of us this weekend.
Exactly.
There's not four.
Yeah.
And in the near future, until something else happens, there's only three of us.
Yep.
And there's two of us during the day.
And that's it. And just kudos to you. Sometimes old-fashioned works. Your help wanted to sign up on the outside.
I got to tell you, the internet, the newspapers,
yeah,
have nothing on that 10-second sign that I built.
I know. I'm giving you kudos for that.
Yeah.
You may get more people coming responding to that.
More people came to that sign than did the internet post.
Nothing wrong with that.
Okay. So thank you for putting that up.
Yeah. I just had a crazy idea to talk about signs. Is there any way... you have peak times and you have slower times, right, Woody?
It's tough to determine when. Yeah, 3:30 is a peak time.
Right. Is there any way that you could put a big sign out that said, temporarily short staff, please come at non-peak hours? I'm serious.
But then everybody comes with that time.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you know, I'm just thinking outside the box.
I'm doing myself at 2 o'clock.
I think I understand where you're going with
yeah.
it. You don't have unintended consequences.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah. Yeah, your new peak time could be when they're trying to have their lunch and they have nobody there.
Oh, well. That's a thought.
Yeah, no, good thought, though.
Absolutely.
Okay.
No, I mean, you know, that's what... We don't... Up here, we don't know all the answers. We don't have all the answers. So anything we can get, you know, that's, you know, helpful for us, that's... You know, a good idea is a good idea. I don't care where it comes from, personally.
Okay, I'm good for that.
All right. All right. So that's this email here, and that one here I'll set there. I had something in mind, and then we thought we were going with it.
We still have the general town business.
Right. No, I know, but I had something that was like, sucks getting old, folks. It really does.
Seeing everybody here is there.
I had a thought and lost it.
Gotcha.
You're in the cover.
So, alrighty. We got left this. I mean, we have the bow time. Is anybody
No, just FYI.
Okay.
It just got, came in the office today.
All right, well, I was just gonna grab one and read it, so I didn't know it was a special thing that we need to.
No, it's just, Bo has us, Bo has us down almost to the penny of what they're getting from us.
Yeah, increased tuition payments, you know, where the students add $493,718 to the school.
Yeah.
I just hope that's a contractual increase and not just that they're recalculating.
No, it's, I'm sure it's above board, yeah. I don't think our school board would put up with it.
I would hope not. Probably not. Alrighty then, go around the table.
I just have one item, just a reminder that, the follow-up construction meeting scheduled for next Monday at 1:00. Everyone's, responded and said that they would, will be there.
Agreed, the second will be in our observation board.
Yep.
Trust you guys will do fine and look forward to hearing about it later. Anything else? Are we looking for, town meeting, we're all set with everything?
For town meeting, I'll have all my notes, typically, you gonna stop by or do you need anything? I mean, we pulled together a lot of documents.
Pretty much got the information. This weekend I'll go over once over and just, if there is, I'll catch up here one day or, well, Tuesday, I won't be able to work, so I'll have time to.
On Tuesday.
Yeah, on Tuesday.
We need to probably need to get on that last warrant article, the illegal one, we probably need to get our act together on that one.
Yeah, we need to take it down.
I already sent it to Michelle tonight, cause I emphasized to the individual wishing to speak on it that, Bob Leonard, that he needs to get his request into me ASAP because tomorrow's Friday, I don't know, I know what their schedule's like and.
Understand, yeah, we wanna definitely nail that down so we don't end up with egg on our face and.
Yeah.
Just to have the knowledge of the background.
Yep.
Sir, you have anything?
I'm good, sir.
I'm off the top of my head, just real quick, we had a fire today, I get to play traffic control today.
Did you?
Yes.
On Twisto?
Yeah, on Twisto, yeah, with the electric wire, the tree was leaning into the wire and it was arcing and sparking and created fire down below and the fire department showed up. But with only one officer at one end, I was at the other end and playing traffic control for a couple hours.
Was it a couple hours?
Oh, easily. No, but they did a real good job, you know, Jason did as well as the fire department to, you know, knock it down before it really got out of control. But, so.
His time card will be in later.
Yes.
Junior gears to duty pay?
That's what I was gonna ask him. Read my mind, I was gonna say, so where do I put in fresh duty pay?
That's on straight time.
I tried.
Well,
I asked Blood McCrew if I get any extra points for the fire department, get any points. He goes, no, but he can get a bottle of water. So, but yeah, no, they get knocked down, everybody did a real good job. So, first week, guys worked together.
That's the way it was today, a lot of issues with the wind and trees down. We had to go with Montalona and, Rob Rogers, there's a couple of them there.
Yeah. Tenny Hill too, right?
Huh?
Tenny Hill?
Tenny Hill, it was a real thing there, that was the prize one, it was a pretty good sized tree.
Yeah, that's your neck of the woods, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was on the other end, Linda's in, she was out of power. We were happy.
The one that was California,
the
Alexander,
we didn't lose it.
Well, speaking of the, you know, since we're, you know, just in general chit chat, otherwise the town for the most part, withstood the windstorms pretty good, except for a few odds and ends.
It was a busy day today.
Yeah.
The past couple of windstorms, I was listening to the, well, of course I scanned the surrounding towns and some of the other towns were getting pounded and, you know, we didn't have any trees down the couple previous storms, but today was really exceptional.
Mm. My highest was 50 miles an hour at my house.
I don't doubt that for a moment. Mm. Everybody was outside, was getting sandblasted and the leaves and stuff were blowing around pretty hard.
Yeah.
It was, the sap buckets took a beating.
Yeah, one of them neighbor's yard fell over, it was one of those blue drums, I mean, I don't know how much he had in it, but sorry to say, there was nothing in it when I picked it up for him. So, well, that's good, at least we didn't have suffer any casualties of any sorts.
Good.
Well, I'm good. You, sir?
Well, the only other thing is, because we already talked about the Historical Society page, which I heard some, and the other thing that was brought to my attention, which you might hear about, is they had an era in their paper also.
Okay.
It said 2017, was a difficult year, and the person said that they already go through that
forecast
year. He said, actually not, that's, we're still in it.
I like the idea of just, before we go to the print, just, you know, give everyone the opportunity to just initial off on it.
But most of the time, those requests come in after they've sent them to me and it's already gone to the printer. Trustee of the trust funds actually sent their list to school board, I think, for their budget. And he said, is this the right report? Because it says 2014. And I was like, I missed that one because it, or 2015, and it should have been 2016. So it happens, but and I had extra eyes. I don't proofread it. I let somebody else proofread it. There's something shifted. It just makes it.
But in case you hadn't heard, I heard about it. It's, it's 2017. Kind of early in the year, but.
For what page is that?
That was for the historical societies. They said 2017 was a difficult year or something like that.
Just make it history early.
Oh.
2017 was not as busy as we would have liked it
there you
to
go
be.
Oh,
you
my. She proved her own. Whoops. Like I said, I try to, you know, delegate some of it because it, a fresh pair of eyes is always good, and then it just keeps me out of the...
But just let them know that it might be busier this year than they anticipate.
Hey, just as a thought, if you're gonna allow extra time for that annual report to be proofread, the stuff's gonna have to be submitted earlier.
I had at least 10 reports that got to me within like 3 days of the final proof.
That's wrong.
Of course it is. And so what I have to do is go through every single page through the index, previous year's index, send them reminders. I mean, there's a lot that, following up with this.
Hopefully have a little bit of help for you next year to someone can
I hope so. I wouldn't have a problem giving it to somebody else. Trust me. Really my market gets behind.
It's a short deadline.
It really is.
To get all that stuff put together and organized without errors is...
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's gotten a lot easier because everybody understands the format. They're really following the one-inch border. It doesn't get into the binding like it has in the past. And the format is the same. It would be nice to have the same font, the same, that type of thing. And it's looking a little more professional, I think. But
still room for improvement.
What would you suggest right now? I know I submitted my early, so I was going out of town.
Yeah.
But what do you say? What do we get? We get 6 weeks now, but maybe we should... literally move it ahead a couple weeks.
Well, no, I've shortened it. Depending on when the... I'll send out notices like middle of December, early December, saying that, reminding them it's coming up. But people have to wait for their financials. They have a lot of things.
Yeah.
They don't get until the third or fourth week of January, so there's really only a small...
And there's also procrastination.
Yeah, I
know.
We won't mention any names.
Hey, I'll take my lumps. I'll own up to it. Two of the reports were mine that came in last minute.
Yeah.
So the two suggestions I like tonight are that one, everyone has every group section has an opportunity to see the final draft.
Come in, yeah.
And we take the non-town official committees.
Yep.
And put them
all in the back.
Yep.
And invite others.
Invite others.
Yes. Oh, that's fine.
Good suggestions.
We get time to create a policy so that way we can keep everything.
Yeah, that would be the key first. Yeah.
So that way there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
We'll add that to our action list on the back.
Yep. I think that's something I'd like to do next week if all goes well. It's going to be sit down and actually come up with a list of stuff that we need to work on this year.
The thing is, your term ends on Tuesday? And you don't get sworn in until Friday.
Well, technically, because I remember one in years past.
Is that what?
that you're still a selectman until the new one's sworn in.
We just have more as a volunteer.
I like that word.
What's that?
Volunteer.
I can do that. You see the paycheck? I think I volunteer already.
Yeah, I think so too. I think you all volunteer.
So you would like me to shoot and have a policy for...
No. Just there and brainstorm what things we need to do this year.
Oh, yeah. Expand on it.
Exactly. So we don't lose anything. I know we've talked about it in the last couple weeks, go through the minutes, that kind of stuff, and come together with a list of things that, we really, and then maybe prioritize it, what's going to be at the top of the list, what's going to be at the bottom.
One thing that's not on here is the personnel plan, because...
Yeah, that's definitely on the top of the list.
It's one of the things I know.
And the ordinances, so you have, already crossed off, but these should not be crossed off.
Well,
But for 2017, now we got, they should be brought back and put 2018.
To review them, what we have currently.
Right, we're getting ready for 2018.
Yep, yep.
So we'll take care of that.
Yep.
I mean, stuff like that, and if you guys wanna brainstorm and think of stuff that we might wanna focus on, we may not get it all done, but, you know, well, I may not be here, I don't know, but if I am, then we'll, you know, try to set up a, cause we have summer hours coming up, and that's in every other week as well. You already set that schedule, right? For summer hours, did we already do that?
Yes.
Right, we did, I mean, that can change.
No, no, I don't, I wasn't planning, I guess, just.
Can I ask one question, though? I noticed that we talked about, you know, every other week in May.
Yep.
Can we just do the whole month in May so that we get rid of anything?
I thought we did.
No, I think we talked, she had talked about maybe doing every other week in May, and, you know, just so that if, when you're starting that break in the summer, there may be less impact with whatever, cause, you know, you're gonna look at things to get ready for next year, and some of these will be warrant articles that don't cost anything, so that's a good thing.
Cause I thought we, it was the original schedule was, it'd start in May, go every other week, and I thought we talked and said no, and we go all the time.
We didn't get into it.
I'd have to look at the minutes, I don't remember.
I'll bring the schedule back out, it'd just be best to review it, that could be changed.
Yeah, I mean, I don't remember.
We'll do the schedule next week, then, next week.
Exactly, just make sure, so that way.
Cause you're coming right in, you're not too far from being in April.
Right.
Yeah.
I mean, one of the.
It just seems like a lot to try to get through.
And it's around the corner, yeah, yeah.
One of the things we need to do, I know we talked about in the past, we haven't really done is, you know, after the election, is start reviewing our policies on an annual basis, just.
Yep.
So, you know, I don't know if Mike has seen all of them, or have them, I don't know if we have them.
I remember buying them, yeah.
So we can review them, and, you know, and if they need updating, we update them, if they don't, they don't, but at least we review them.
Yeah.
I know we've talked about that, and, but anyway, for next week, we can kick that around in the work session, I guess.
And we make a, temporary calendar for what we want.
Yeah.
Goals to make that.
Yep, goals.
My dates.
Yep.
So, you know, that way it'll kinda help us pull our feet to the fire and get it done.
Yeah, our feet, yeah.
Yep. That was just my thought.
No, I think we're all agreeing.
How that works, that's so we can get some of this out of the way, and we're not.
Before the summertime.
And we're not getting tied up when it's every other week.
Yeah.
You know, you may not have time to get to some of these things.
Yeah, that's one of the bigger things we do every other week, so we have more time to work on it.
And the next thing you know, it's fall, and then you're worrying about.
Budget coming up.
Budget.
Yeah, there's really not a lot of downtime, because after town meeting, the assessor will be in, going through annual pickups, those are done by April 1st.
Doing the audit.
Then that goes into, I've already gotten, started with the audit, but the assessing data needs to be updated in the tax program, and then roll right into a commission, has to be ready, you know, beginning of May.
October 6th tax rate.
I need to bring in order.
I'm taking good notes.
I just, I didn't, yeah, I do have the audio.
Yep.
But, we'll be busy in the next few weeks.
No, I have no doubt.
Okay.
Hopefully I'm here to help you out a little bit.
Yeah.
Anything else, sir?
That's it.
You? I guess we'll open up a poll of comments.
Okay, I have another thing today.
Yep.
Actually,
Leo, you sit there, we'll start this way, Tom.
A couple of weeks ago, the state reps came in.
Yep.
And there was a discussion about the loss of tax revenue from the flood control lands. And Neil Kirk sits on the committee that's gonna.
Finance committee, he's the chair of it.
Right. Is there, I was thinking, like, couldn't we get the selectmen who are being impacted by this together to, you know, craft a letter to send to them to.
Yeah, and I don't mean to be, you know, not flippant, but, opportunistic, but I was actually just thinking about that the other day. You know, the selectmen get together, write a
but I mean,
like
not just.
Letter, but all the different towns, Hopkins, and Ware, Dunbarton,
exactly.
Oh God,
Webster, probably,
yep.
You know, there's
a
few towns.
We actually have a template of a letter that someone from Hopkinton, are you talking about the,
flood control.
The flood
control.
I have a folder with a letter that was drafted by a selectman in Hopkinton.
Oh, right.
And we signed it.
Recently?
A three, four years ago.
Might be time to,
do it again.
Do it again, you know, and maybe to reinforce, especially to our representatives here, because I know Mary Beth is in favor of us getting the money. I know some have voted against us getting the money, so we got to reinforce.
Well, if you said send it to our own representatives, send it to all the representatives, so that way when it comes up.
They... Right, of course. But I mean, they're here to represent us, and they should hear us and say, okay, you're right, you know.
I'll scan that letter to you.
There's quite a few of this, Henniker.
Henniker. Yeah. So, you know.
I'll scan that letter to you so you can see what was said.
About half a dozen towns, I think, in, that, in this part of the flood control.
Well, just a thought. I figured maybe I'd throw that out and see what you guys think, you know.
We'd like to invite those our reps back again, and we invite our senator back again, too. It'd be nice to have him show up, but I think before...
Yeah, you can do it on a quarterly basis.
Yeah, oh, and maybe well before the next session when the new bills are coming in, too.
Yeah, yeah. If there's any bill out there that will affect us, you might want to let us know about it before they show up so we can be ready for the questions.
It bothered me when one of our reps said, well, that's $80 million. He's talking about the retirement system, bringing only 15% paid by the state. The thing is, the state stole it from us at the beginning.
Right.
We want our money back.
Yeah. Well, you're not going to get it, but...
No, but the thing is, he said, well, it's an $80 million hole. Who's going to pay for it? Well, that's not my problem. We just want the money back to the town.
Well, that's
the
way responsibility is reps.
That's the way it works. Right.
Right. I know.
The property taxpayer is also footing the bill for the lack of any other taxation that they don't want. So basically, they're taxing you behind your back. You
know? Absolutely. I mean, it's like from a meals tax, they want to cap it at 2017 levels. 2018, 2019, they could have a windfall, you know, because the economy's doing much better, construction's doing better. I mean, people are out there spending money,
so
the whole nine yards. And guess what happens? They get the windfall, and we end up paying more out of our tax levels.
Yeah. So as I always say, you know, they're very proud to say we don't have an income tax or a sales tax, but that's they're taking it out of our pocket anyways.
Right. Mm-hmm.
They just don't tell you that part.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
No, you're good. Who's the state senator? Did he ever get in touch with you?
Neither the secretary or he responded back.
Yes. So I'll have to keep on him, though, if I can.
Kudos for having the representatives and said, I do that again, please. I was not here, but I watched it online, as I always do, and it was very informative, and I'd like to see you do it again.
Like I'm on a quarterly basis, so that kind of
like
so
every 6 months or something.
What,
just, you know, not so much that it becomes a burden and everyone else jumps on the bandwagon, but I definitely like that, and, you know, I'll think of some questions. And
if we know of bills coming up that they're going to be voting on,
we could put that in the town crier.
Talk about it.
You could put that in the town crier on the Sunday paper when they're going to be coming in, and they can email their questions to the town office.
Yeah, maybe we can get them before the budget gets passed, because there's a few articles in the trailer bill that affect us, you know, as far as our tax dollars.
Really?
Or lack of, I should say.
And I appreciate that email you sent out with all the bills that are affecting us. I think
that's all one bill. That's just the articles.
I know, all the different articles. Yeah. I appreciate all the information.
And I'll try to get out to
everyone that I thought was a great idea. Thank you.
You're welcome. Les, anything more to say?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Woody? Chief? No, I thought you said no. Did you?
No, I'm good.
Okay, that's what I thought.
No, I'm good, thank you.
All right. Hey, before you take off, I just want to touch base with you real quick on something privately.
I'll be here.
Come on. Tom.
I miss you guys.
Hmm?
I miss you guys, that's why I saw the lights on a few swinging.
Well, thank you. I miss you too. But we got a good replacement for you. But
you're working.
It's not
you're working me.
Yeah. Oh, doing good. How goes the battle?
Good. Things are good.
Excellent. And no, you can't have the cane.
Why do you stick? The husband's stick. Then we get damaged, I'm sure. Or left in the woods.
Oh, we don't want to do that.
No.
So. All right, folks, then I'm going to close public comment. There's no more. We do have a non-public for RSA 91-A:3-2B. There'll be a short public afterwards. It's basically, you know, B is going into as far as hiring people, so when we come out, we'll make a motion to take care of that. That's about it. That's my knowledge.
Okay.
So,
see you guys.